At the moment, the Trilogue negotiations are taking place on the TCO regulation. It is the regulation on prevention of the dissemination of terrorist content online, which could introduce upload filters and also include the one-hour rule. One of the shadow rapporteurs, which are responsible for the terror regulation, is our MEP Patrick Beyer. Hello, Patrick.
Hi.
Patrick, what can you first please summarize what the TCO regulation is about and what is the problem with this regulation?
So TCO regulation is a proposed EU law on the prevention of terrorist content online. So it has a very far-reaching aim to prevent the publication of terrorist content. And that, of course, means huge problems for internet users and freedom of speech online. First of all, a one-hour rule is supposed to make sure that operators of internet hosting service will delete terrorist content within 1 hour of receiving an order, even at nighttime or during weekend, which is hardly feasible for many small and non-commercial companies, but also for startups, for example. Furthermore, the proposal wants to introduce compulsory upload filters. And that, of course, is wrought with problems because they again and again block legitimate content because of the way that technology can't tell legal from illegal content. Then there is a danger that legitimate users of terrorist content, for example, photos of attacks, could vanish, such as media reporting, such as critical posts on terrorism, public awareness raising, scientifically dealing with the phenomenon of terrorism. All those are legitimate reasons to use terrorist content. And finally, there is a danger that cross-border removal orders, meaning that the government of Hungary, for example, could order the removal of content in any other EU country, even content that is legal in that country, result in the risk that these removal orders could be used for political purposes. So ministers could be tempted to present themselves as law and order people by, you know, taking down lots of content or a website. And that's a great danger for freedom of speech online and also for our possibilities to receive information.
After Article 13, the Commission is now trying again to introduce upload filters. Why are we private still regarding the use of upload filters as very critical?
Well, first of all, they are ineffective. They are so easy to circumvent. If upload filters just use hash databases, they can be circumvented by modifying a video just a little and it won't be recognized. That has been repeatedly done to spread terrorist material. Secondly, upload filters never understand the context of a publication, which means that if you publish an image or a video with on terrorism, it can be propaganda if it's done by a terrorist group with the intention to provoke people to support terrorism, but it can also be legitimate media coverage. It can be criticism of terrorism. It can be scientifically analyzing how terrorist groups work or public awareness raising. And upload filters will never understand the difference, which means that they systematically overblock legal content. And finally, review procedures that are being offered are not really helping these problems because it takes too long. Hardly anyone will really take the trouble, and even if in the end something is restored, some content is restored, it will usually no longer be up to date, so nobody will care by the time that a mistake is corrected. And therefore, upload filters are a great danger to our freedom of expression. They make it difficult for small services to comply. They can't really afford to develop such technologies, and it could result in some services blocking EU users just because they can't satisfy these requirements.
You have already mentioned the one-hour rule. What is the problem with this rule?
Yes, so individuals or non-commercial organizations or small startups may not have the resources to answer to these orders within 1 hour, even at night and during the weekend. And therefore, there is a danger that they might actually just simply shut down their services if they can't comply, because they face substantial penalties if they repeatedly don't comply. And it also disadvantages European internet operators in comparison to those global internet corporations. They will have the staff to comply within 1 hour, but we really want to grow a European internet industry and environment, and this is really counterproductive because it makes it impossible for European operators to comply.
Considering that both the Council and the Commission are not willing to amend the 1 hour rule, how could we make sure that this does not create any burden to small and medium enterprises and also to startups?
Okay, so the least we need to do is create exceptions for small organizations who cannot comply for operational or technical reasons. You know, if they follow orders as soon as possible, it is really has to be good enough to prevent them from having to shut down.
I believe that now it should be clear for everyone why the TCO regulation is problematic. So what can everyone do to prevent the TCO regulation?
So this regulation will have to be decided by the European Parliament and by the EU national governments represented in council. And at the moment, the EU Parliament is standing up for our rights and for the internet community, but the national governments and the Commission only care about effectiveness and removing, preventing as much as possible. And therefore, how you can help is contacting your national government, your Ministry of the Interior, or the permanent representations of other governments here in Brussels to tell them about your concerns. And another thing you can do is to raise public awareness and attention on this upcoming regulation that's being negotiated. For example, by discussing it with your friends and family or posting about it on your social media accounts, by making videos on the issue or sharing my blog posts on Terek, or even raising the attention of local media to this issue. We need this attention and debate in order to create a public pressure on the council and the governments to take our needs into account and make sure that our fundamental rights and freedoms and the needs of the internet community are respected.
Okay, thank you very much for this interview, Patrick. So more information about the TCO regulation and also about what you can do against it can be found on Patrick's website and also by clicking on the links in the video description.